from Akaash Maharaj, who went to Teddy Hall, says, you've been quoted as saying that Oxford needs greater ideological diversity and a willingness to engage with discomforting ideas. You know, what in your judgment, he asks, is the source of the current lack of ideological diversity, and how do you think about that?
My point was that we have to listen to our critics, who sometimes think we are overprivileged, overprecious, and that we have not enough ideological diversity. We were, for example, overwhelmingly on the side of, as was I, unashamedly so, but we overwhelmingly against Brexit. The vast majority of academics consider themselves liberals. And I think it is healthy to have a bigger mix so that it can be normal for our students to hear academics engage with one another, disagree with one another in an atmosphere of robust civility. And I think it's partly because students don't see that, that then when they hear a view that they disagree with, they want to be protected from that view. And I don't think we should be protecting students from views they don't like. I think we should be exposing them to those views. And I think part of education is about robbing students of their certitudes and showing them how to engage with others. I mean, the Augustinian precept of audi alteram partem, listen to the other side. I mean, that's what we need to do in university. So that was the point I was making. I was trying to say, we've got to listen to our critics, engage with our critics. We're far from perfect. But that got totally distorted in the media, but such is life. So the real question is, what is the source of it? I honestly don't know what the source of it is. What I worry, to be honest, is that there's too much self-censorship going on, that people who do hold contrary views against to the mainstream self-censor and don't feel comfortable being public about them, precisely because of the sense that there isn't adequate tolerance for contrary points of view. And that's really antithetical to what a university is all about. Our whole reason for being is to engage in ideas, to engage in arguing, to kind of seek truth through reasoned debate. And I worry that we're losing that. We're not alone in that. And my reference, I wasn't at all talking about Oxford. I was talking about universities generally. So it's a difficult one. Again, if anybody, any, well, very welcome to listen to advice on that.